YouTube, what is good? Today I'm going to be showing you guys a popular haircut in the barbershop, and it's a clean taper into curls. So let's get it.
Whoa. Clap the room, I'm coming through. They want to see what I'm about. Yeah, I got skills, do it for the thrill. I'm on a paper route. Extra, read about it. I'm today's trying to tap it.
What is good, family? It is Dre back again with another tutorial. So let's dive right in. We're gonna start off by clipping up the client's hair and getting ready to start this taper. So we're gonna start off in the back. We're gonna create our bald line just under the bottom of his ear, and we're gonna go straight across. Now we're gonna flip the trimmer around and bald everything under that line out, letting the weight of the trimmer do the work so we don't cause too much irritation on the client's skin, because this area tends to be very sensitive. And now to get it a little closer to the skin, we're gonna grab our foil shavers and bald it out a little more. Now to get into the next step, we're gonna come in with our lever all the way open here, and we're gonna go up about a finger's width, a thumb's width here. Make sure we give ourselves some room to blend. And now I'm going to go ahead and close that lever and gradually open it as I showed you guys. So I'm coming in closed here, just tapping at that line, moving up slightly. Then as I go up, I'm going to open that lever a little more until we get to the top of that guideline and that lever is completely open. And it might not be perfect the first time through. That's where you'll see me play with the lever going open to close until I get that line nice and blended out. Staying real consistent here, real patient. And now to get into the next step, I'm gonna come in with my one guard open, and again I'm showing you guys, I'm going about a thumb's width here, right above that lever, all the way open. And we're staying real consistent, making sure our guidelines are nice and even and not all zigzaggy. Now to follow that up and get rid of the line in between that lever open and that one guard open, I'm gonna come in with my half guard here. And you'll see towards his nape area, it's growing sideways, as opposed to the middle of his nape area, grows up and down. So that's why I'm coming in sideways with the clipper here, all the way open. And then I'm gonna close it a little until that line is completely blended out. And I don't know about y'all, but I know early on when I started to learn how to cut hair, I really struggled with tapers more than I did with fades, just for the simple fact that it's in such a small, tight area. And man, not to mention it's a long hair like this. I always used to struggle with the blending aspect of it, so I'm hoping this video helps you in some way, shape, or form. So we're still working right here with the half guard, using the corner of the blade to get into those, you know, those little crevices. And now following that up, we're gonna come in with our two guard open here. And you'll see me really exaggerate the flick out motion as I move up into his curls. And that's because right here, I'm trying to create shape. And now right under that two guard open, I'm going to come in with my one and a half guard all the way open. And we're just going to attack that line. So I'll start open and then gradually close that lever as needed. Just like I did with the other steps, I always like to start open and then close it gradually as needed, just to be on the safer side. Then I went ahead and closed that lever. And now that one and a half didn't really do the job, so I'm coming back here with my one guard open, and I saw open wasn't doing the job, so I closed the lever just a little bit. And we're just trying to detail here, get that taper nice and blurry and consistent all the way through. And you can see as we come in with those corners and just attack those dark areas, this taper is really starting to come together. And now to blend into the length on the top slightly better, I'm going to come in with my foreguard here. And we're not trying to create a line, we're just trying to debulk and blend into those curls. So I'm going to start off with this fore and then move to smaller guards gradually. So I'm just flicking with that four And now right under that four, I'm gonna come in with my three guard open. And we're doing the same thing here. We're coming in and we're just flaring out very exaggerated like. And that's because we're trying to get this blend as seamless as possible without creating any lines. And now on his right side right here, that dark spot I was having a lot of trouble getting rid of. So I'm coming in here with my tool guard open. And then right there I went ahead and closed it. Just trying to lighten that up and bring it all together. Now we're gonna come in with our 1.5 open here. And then I went ahead and closed the lever, cause like I said, I always start open and then close it. And it's starting to lighten up a little bit. So now we're gonna move to even smaller guard, which is our one guard all the way open. Really using the corner of the blade to get into that area, cause we don't wanna take off too much. And you can already see how that dark spot got blended out. Now we're going to use some clipper over comb. And this is just to smooth everything out. Get that transition into the curls very nice. And you can already see that taper really came together here. Now it's time to get into the side taper. So I'm going to start right where the end of his eyebrow is, and then I'm going to connect that right to where the ear connects to the head. And then I'm going to give it that nice burst effect, so that way I could keep the corners of his lineup very dark. So now I'm going to use my trimmer to bald that out, and we're going to follow the same exact systems as we did on the neck area. So I'm balding him out with the trimmers here. Now we're gonna follow it up with the shaver to get it nice and close to the skin and really make that taper pop. Now we're gonna follow that up with the lever all the way open. And we're gonna go up about a finger's width here. With the sides, I don't like to go up as high as I do with the back, because in the back we have a lot more surface area that we have to blend out. And on the sides, we're working in a much tighter area. But I'm still keeping that burst effect, and now I'm gonna close that lever. And as I move up in the guideline, I'll go ahead and open up that lever. But you can already see on the side with the lever closed, it pretty much already got rid of that line. Now we're gonna follow that step up with our one guard all the way open here. Still maintaining that burst effect. But you're gonna see as I move towards his ear, I kind of cut sideways like I did in his nape area. And that's because the hair is growing towards his ear as we get closer to it. So right here, you'll see me try to go against the grain. And you always want to make sure you're cutting against the grain to get the, you know, the most smooth effect when fading. And now to get rid of that line in between the open and one guard, even though it is faint, we're gonna use our half guard here with the lever all the way open. And then we'll close that lever up. And it's really important to use the corner of your blade when doing the side taper, especially just because it's such a tight area. You know what I'm saying? And now we're going to follow that up with our two guard open here. Not trying to create too harsh of a line. Really flicking out as we move up towards the top of that taper. But you can already see how this taper is starting to come together slowly but surely. Now we're gonna come in with our 1.5 open here and just work out that line. And the reason we have my client's hair sectioned off here is because he's gonna grow out his hair just slightly, and it allows me to see you know, all the lining a lot better, as opposed as if the hair was just down, you know what I'm saying. And now we're gonna come in with our four guard here, and I'm not shaving up to the top of that sectioned off part where the clips are at. I'm kind of flaring out and coming off the shape of his head here, and that's because I don't want to give him that undercut look. And now to go ahead and blend into that weight a little bit nicer, I'm going to come in with my thinning shears here. So I'm coming in with the comb and then just flaring out slightly. And once I take these clips out and let the hair fall back to its natural position, you're going to see how it blends very nicely. And now we're gonna go ahead and line up his nape area. And when lining that up, I always like to start at the top of the ear just so I prevent taking that area up too high. And then after we do that, we're gonna go to the bottom of his nape area and connect all of it in the middle. And that's how I'm gonna get that nice shape around the ear without digging into it too much. And now we're gonna recomb it to make sure we get all those loose hairs. And you can already see when you put the line on it, it really makes that taper come together and bring out any imperfections that you might need to go back in detail. And now we're gonna get into the taper on the other side. And on this side, I'm not gonna do too much explaining just because we're following the same exact systems as we did on his right side and on the back of his neck. So I'm gonna let you guys watch and kind of put the pieces together yourself. But a word of encouragement for you guys learning how to cut hair, right? I know the process can be frustrating. I know the process can be discouraging because you feel like you want to get to this certain place in your skill set and in your career, and it feels like it's taking forever. But listen, fam, enjoy the process, all right? Have fun. Every single person that sits in your chair should be a learning experience, and it should be fun. You know what I'm saying? Learning how to talk to people and maneuver different personalities and different systems to get the best possible outcome. Fam, enjoy the process. Have fun along the journey, right? Because once you get there, you're there. And ain't no taking it away. You know what I'm saying? So enjoy the process. I know it can be frustrating. I know it can be discouraging, especially when you hop on Instagram or social media and you start comparing yourself to other people. Fam, don't do that. It's gonna hinder your growth. It's gonna hinder your journey. All right, focus on yours, not what the other person is doing, but focus on your journey. All right, and enjoy all of it because it's fun. It's fun to look back and see the progress that you made after the fact and be like, wow, you know what I'm saying? So enjoy the process, family. Enjoy it. Because I know the long hours you put in. I know the grinding you've been doing to really perfect your craft and get better at what you do, right? Especially so you can live the best possible life that you can, to set up your future family, to set up yourself, your future kids. I know the hard work you put it in, and you will reap the rewards from that hard work. But be patient, right? Be patient and trust that God will reward you for that hard work you've put in. You feel me? So right here, we're just continuing to come in with that one guard and just detail this taper, figuring out what works and what doesn't. And now, just like we did on the other side, we're going to come in with our four guard here, and we're not shaving up to that part line. We're kind of coming off the shape of his head so that way we can keep the area as dark as possible. So when we let the curls off of the clips, it kind of falls nicely and it looks like it's all blended. And now on this side, we're going to come in with our thinning shears just to go ahead and smooth out this taper and make sure that transition into that weight at the top of that taper is nice and smooth. And you can see that taper came together very nicely. Now we're going to line up the other side. So we're starting at the top of his ear, making sure that that's nice and crisp and natural. And now we're going to go to the bottom and connect those two points in the middle. And that's how you're going to get that nice, nape lineup. We're going to comb it down, get rid of all those hairs hanging over. And that taper is really popping now that we put the line on there. But not sure, now you're going to see what I'm saying. So I'm going to take off the clips that were holding off the back of his hair, or holding up the back of his hair. And when you pull that over, it kind of looks all even and all blended. Now we're going to move on to his front lineup. So I'm going to reclip the front, make sure that all his lineup hairs are combed forward. And I'm lifting up the hair here so you can see that those are bangs. So this is not a pushback. So we're going to start in the middle, and we're gonna move to either the left or right side, whichever you're more comfortable with. Trying to keep this as natural as possible while at the same time getting it as crispy as possible. And especially with a lineup like this, you want to make sure that you're constantly combing the hair and making sure that it's laying down. So that way, when he goes home, takes a shower, and goes to comb his hairline, he doesn't have a whole bunch of loose hairs hanging over. So we're moving towards his left side here. Now we're going to line up his vertical bar. And that lineup is hitting, boy. So we're combing again right here. Then we're going to go ahead and reline it. And it's coming together very nicely. Now we're going to use some trimmer over comb right here to get rid of some weight that's along that arch area. Now we're going to start at the top of the arch. And then we're going to go to the bottom of the arch and meet those two points in the middle. And that's how you're going to get the most natural C-cup while at the same time getting it crispy and family. This taper is looking nice once we put the lineup on there. And now we're just tapping, really making that line sharp with these trimmers. And I don't know about y'all, but that taper is looking tough. Now we're going to move on to his other side, doing the same exact thing, making sure that it's symmetrical with the left side that we just completed. Now we're going to start at the most natural point at the top of his arch, then the most natural point at the bottom of his arch, and then meet it in the middle. And now we are going to add some enhancement to really make his lineup pop. So I want to go ahead and comb those hairs back and then spray it on the line that we just created. And the reason I'm combing the hairs back is just so it's getting on the skin. And now I'm going to go ahead and dry it and comb those hairs back down in its natural, in the way that it naturally wants to lay. And now we're going to go ahead and hit it with the razor. Now this razor is going to get rid of all those stubbles that the trimmer couldn't necessarily get and really take that lineup to the next level. And you'll see that I'm pulling the skin in the opposite direction from which I'm using the razor. And that's so I create enough tension to where I won't cut the client, which is very important. You don't want to cause any irritation on the client's skin or cuts, you know what I'm saying? And now we're going to take those clips out and pull the hair down. And you can all see how it came together. Family, this is how my client came in looking. This is how he left, leaving a nice, simple taper into the curls. A very popular haircut in the shop. Family, if this video helps you in any way, shape, or form, make sure you hit that like and subscribe button and drop a comment down below. And while you're at it, give me a follow on IG where I have a lot more dope content. But again, I will catch y'all next time.